Hello, I'm Vaos, and welcome to the Doom Wars. The Doom Wars is a Skulldark mod made by Captain Ventress, and unlike most Doom-based gameplay, this isn't about shooting people in the face with shotguns at the edges. This is about summoning hordes of monsters to defeat your enemies and be the last one standing. I'll be showing you a quick introduction of what this mod is about and how it plays. So let's get started. First, you can play a different faction that are from the Doom Engine games, like of course Doom, but also Heretic, Exen, Strife, Shex Quest, and Virus, which is a Doom mod. So let's just play with Doom Guy. It would be more simple to understand. Here we are. Just spawn and the enemies are already in the game fighting us. So let's just summon some units to fight them. Summoning Nerf costs mana, as you can see in the top right. And yeah, our shotgunners are fighting and killing stuff. First thing, when you kill enemies, you can get some mana back from them, from this little bottle. They could be green bottle for 1 mana, purple bottle for 2 mana, blue bottles for 5 mana, sorry, and red bottles for 25, but we won't be seeing them often. So let's summon more guys. As you can see, summoning stuff through a little blue projectile. It will summon something when it hits the ground or a wall. But sometimes you try to summon stuff near other monsters, it won't work. But we'll be seeing that soon. And we just got new units. So in this mod, to get new units, you have to check your tech tree. You have to bind a key in the customing control menu. Just press up and bind the key to Z Doom Wars toggle tech tree. I like to bind air myself, but it's as you want. As you can see, this is a Doom tech tree. To summon stuff that is at the bottom, you have to summon stuff that's more up in the tree. Like by summoning zombie men and shotgun guys, we just unlock imps, chain gunners, and pinkies. So let's try getting more units, like specters. Do we have to summon some pinkies? And yeah, like you just saw, trying to summon stuff too close from wall or summoning stuff near other units may result in the summon failing and you losing your mana, so watch out. And we just unlock Spectres. Spectres are marionettes, like the pinkies, but they are the ghosts, as you can see in the sprite of your weapon. It's grey instead of being just normal yellow, orange-ish. Since it's about a little peculiarity, you might be confused the first time. You see, the Doom Wars is that some of the shots go through. For instance, shotgun guys can't hit them. They can't eat ghosts, but zombie men now can. The units are also quite different from the originals. Like for instance, zombie men have more health now, and have more precise at long range. Spectres also have more health than pinkies, but cost more. And some other stuff. Let's just try summoning more stuff for now. More spectres. Set of vectors, you get L Knights. L Knights, which are very good melee units, and we just unlock Barons and the Cyber Demon. Each class has a few hero units. In case of Doom, the Spider Masterman and the Baron of Hell. Astra is not a hero, it's just a normal unit. And you can summon those. I'm just waiting for the mana to come back. I didn't mention it, but there is 2 mana type, as you can see on the description there. Summoning summoners require 2 types of mana. The normal one, that you can get by waiting or getting bottles, and the second one, which is hero mana. You can only get this one by waiting, and you have much less of this one than normal one. This to prevent spamming of big units. Let's get our Cyber Demon now. Here he is. Or in his might. Summoning heroes put a cooldown on the unit itself. So you can like wait to have full mana and summon two Saber Demon at once. You have to wait 5 minutes. Lesser heroes like Spider Mastermind or for other factions have lesser cooldowns. And what one last thing? Every faction has a special ability. Like for the Doom Guy has Vipers that can heal the top left. After spawning Pen Elementals, we unlock the Archfey and the Vipers. The Vipers is an ability that summon 3 or 4 ghost Archfeys that are invincible and will summon 4 units before vanishing. Could be quite good because it allows you to resurrect stuff without having summoned 1 Archfey. Other factions have different abilities like Ghost Wave to turn units into ghosts and make them translucent. Or for instance, which other? Like the Enchant ability for Exen that make units reflect shots. No, reflect shots I think, and less. Yes, there also are less. I don't remember that. Sorry, my bad. I should read the manual more. So yeah, this mod has a manual, even more manual. It one for each faction that explain quickly the units, the weaknesses, the use and stuff. If you want to read it, you can. If you don't care, you don't have to care. You learn stuff on the go. And just one last thing, let's summon some chain gunners. We got revenants, and we got something else, a blue revenant. So we can summon upgraded units. We have a normal revenant, which shoots fireballs, and this Raygun revenant, which has a different sprite and shoots Raygun shots, which is a good sniper then. So there is also a retrofit upgrade, which you can use to like shoot a little fireball to upgrade units. It's not very practical, I also like to summon upgraded units instantly. But let's try out regardless. Yeah, upgraded into a Raygun revenant, sprite change. Some factions come with upgrades that affect all units, but I will show you right now. For instance, if I play Jax Quest, I can upgrade my basic unit with this upgrade. It's a common flame upgrade that makes him split on death. No, not split, but drop spurs on death and spur transform later into common flamoids. So if I summon flamoids, use upgrade and summon more only the new one we have the upgrade. That's pretty much it, and I guess I will see you guys later in a quick match video.